right, so today we are going to be doing a little paper circuitry, and you are going to learn how to connect some LEDs in this card to make your snowman light up when you press down. And so the way that we're going to do that is by connecting these two LEDs with some copper tape all the way around the card to a battery. And I will show you how to do that step by step in just a second. But before we get started with that, there is one or two things that you need to know about LEDs and circuits. So a couple of terms to learn and a couple of things to learn about the way the LEDs work. So you're gonna be working with, I'm just gonna do a quick sketch here, it's a little bit long, of an LED. And this is called an LED. And an LED actually stands for a light emitting. Emitting means to give off. So a light emitting, it gives off light, diode. Okay. Now the di in diode means two. And if you look at your LED, you'll see that the LED has how many legs? It has two legs. And I'm gonna grab my actual LED here to show you that as well. So there is my actual LED. And it's clear, so a little tricky to see on the white paper, but you can see that there are two legs on that LED. Now, what's important to notice here is that those legs are not the same length. So one of those legs is going to be longer than the other one. That long leg is what we will call our positive leg. So go ahead and say that with me. This is the positive leg. And then this short one is our negative leg. So go ahead and say that with me, the negative leg. Great. Now this is important because when you are connecting your LED to its power source, if we do not connect the LED in the correct way or in the correct order, it actually won't light up. And so we can go ahead and test that out. You have, a little battery pack, something kind of like this. You're gonna go ahead and you're going to pop that battery out of its packaging. And the first thing that we'll do is test our LED. So once you get your battery out, set it down in front of you. And I want you to notice which side has the plus sign on it, which side is going to be positive, and which side has a negative sign or no mark on it at all. And that would be our negative side. So if you need to, go ahead and pause right now and get that battery opened up and on the table in front of you. And now that you have your battery, you're gonna take your LED, you're gonna make sure that you see the long leg, the positive leg, and the negative leg. And we're actually gonna take this battery and test our LED by sliding the battery between the two legs of the LED. And we need to make sure that that positive leg is the one that's touching the positive side of the battery. And so if we do that, then there we go. Our LED should light up. You can also test the other direction and see what happens. So if I flip my LED over so that the short leg, the negative side, is now touching the positive side of the battery, you'll see that nothing's going to happen. And so we want to test this out because oftentimes in our electronics projects, if our LED isn't doing what we want, one of the things we want to check first is, do we have the legs connected in the right direction or the right order so that positive is touching positive and negative is touching negative. Okay. All right, after we do that test, you can go ahead and set these aside because you're not going to need them for just a minute. We are going to look at the inside of our card and how we're going to put that together. So inside my card, if I open this up, you'll see I have this whole path of copper tape running along here and another path running along here. And that's going to be the first step in our project. So let's get out our blank piece of paper. Go ahead and put your snowman paper in front of you. There's the snowman on the back. And make sure that you're looking at the copper tape path. Now, what's nice about this page is that it is a labeled diagram. So it actually tells you on the page where you're gonna put everything that you need. And so if you forget the instructions, make sure that you look on the paper and see if it does indeed tell you what it is you're going to do. Now, at this point, I just want you to watch all the way through how I put my copper tape down. Do not touch your copper tape yet. This copper tape is a little bit fragile. These pieces will rip really, really carefully and stick to each other really, really well, and then you will not have any copper tape to use anymore, okay? So we're using copper tape because copper is what we call conductive, and conductive materials are materials that work really well for passing electricity from one place to another. So electricity likes conductive materials, okay? Copper is very conductive. Now, what I'm gonna do with my copper tape is, on the back, it's got this white paper, just like a sticker. So the first thing that I'm gonna do, remember, don't do this yet, you're just gonna watch first. Okay, oh, now I'm gonna have trouble getting this off of here. So I actually sometimes just kind of like bend a corner to loosen it, and then I have a little bit easier time getting my nail under there. There we go. All right, now what I'm gonna do is just peel a little bit of my copper tape back. I'm not gonna take the whole thing apart. Okay, oh, I'm gonna stop right there. Leave the backing on the rest of your tape because we don't want it to curl up on itself and stick together and then we don't have any more tape. So I just peeled a little bit back, and now very carefully, I'm gonna lay this copper tape down on the path. Try to go right to the end there. There we go. I'm gonna stick it down really nice and tight, and then I'm gonna just pull back a little at a time while I'm sticking. So press down, pull back, press down, pull back. All right, now when I get to the corner, I do not want to tear my tape off here. We wanna try and keep our tape in one long piece all the way around if we can. So these corners can be tricky. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna pull just a little bit more of the back off. And then sometimes what I do is I'll kind of go, let's see, I'm gonna press this down to the end right here. And then what helps me is if I put one finger under the tape and kind of like you push in to kind of guide the tape. And then with my other hand here, I'm gonna turn around the corner while I'm pushing in with my left hand and turning with my right hand. And then I'm just gonna actually press down and stick the tape kind of down on top of itself. And it's kind of like a little bit of a messy corner, but that worked. That worked pretty good. So now you can see what my corner looks like, okay? And then you're gonna need to go all the way, right, to the corner. The best advice I can give you is you're gonna go slow and steady. Make sure that tape is nice and flat and neat, okay? You get a much better connection if your copper tape is flat and neat. And uh-oh, I have a corner again. So let's see, I'm gonna put one finger under here to kind of push it backwards while I'm also turning. Let's see, Okay, press down. There we go. Okay, I got it. Now, I'm gonna stop here, okay? So if you want to, this is a good place to pause the video and start your copper tape line and then stop your tape here. Do not cut it, leave it connected, and then maybe you wanna start the video again for the next part. Or you can just continue watching through this step and then you can go ahead and do your own. Okay. So on our next step, you'll see these LED marks on our map here. So what we're actually gonna have to do now is get our LEDs, and this little dot is where we're gonna set the LED down, but you can see it's not gonna set down very well with the legs flat. These legs are pretty bendable. Now they are fragile, so if you bend them too many times, they will break off. So we do need to be gentle, but they are meant to be bent a little bit. And so we're gonna bend them out flat like our LEDs doing the splits. However, don't forget which leg is the longer one, because you can see on our map here, we have to put the long leg on this side and the short leg on this side. So here's my long leg. So I'm gonna remember that. I'm gonna bend these out flat. And then I'll put that down. Oops, see, now I already forgot. Okay, I'm just gonna bend it. Oh, this was the long leg. This was the long leg. If I do it the wrong way, my LEDs are definitely not gonna light up with my battery. So, okay, now I have to hold this down, right? It might stand up by itself, let's see. Okay, not bad, yeah, that'll stand. And then I can go all the way down, all the way down. Okay, all the way down. No need to rush, take your time. Okay, oh, and then I'll have another LED to do down here. I'm only gonna do one right now. So I'm actually just gonna stop right here. And then, like I said, this tape tears really easily. So even if I don't have scissors, I can go ahead and just like tear that off. Okay, because I'm just gonna do my one LED. Then you're gonna do the same thing along here. Do not put your battery down. Put your copper tape down first, all the way along the line, and make sure it's nice and tight and secure. Okay. And then after you have your copper tape all the way around, and I'll go back to my original one. After your copper tape is all the way around and your LEDs have been taped down, then you can take your battery and you can test your card out, and you'll see there are some directions. It says negative facing down. Okay, so there's my negative down, there's my positive. So my tape runs up through the circle. I'm gonna set my battery on top of my tape, and now nothing is gonna happen yet because I only have the negative side connected. And remember when we tested our LED and the battery alone, both legs were touching the battery. So in order for both legs, for these legs to touch, we actually have to fold our card closed and press down. And then you should get an LED to light up. Don't worry if you only get one LED working. You might not get both working. These batteries are 3-volt batteries. And these LEDs are 3-volt LEDs, meaning one LED by itself requires 3 volts of power to run. So sometimes this battery might not give off enough power, especially if I've been using it a lot. It might not give off enough power for both LEDs, but mine has been sitting around all day, not used too much. And I'm able right now to press down and light up my lights. If you have trouble with your LEDs, they may not light up the first time. There's a couple things to try. One would be, again, tighten your connection. And on these LEDs, I actually had a little copper tape left over. So I took some of my leftover copper tape and I cut a little piece and I put it on top of these legs here to tighten them down even more. So the tighter the copper tape is, the better the connection. The other thing is, I mentioned earlier, nice and smooth copper tape. So if you really go over it again and just smooth it down again, that helps sometimes too. Sometimes you might have to wiggle these around a little bit and just get them, do that, and just nice and tight. You might have to play with it a little bit. So if it doesn't work the first time, don't give up. Play with it a little bit. Try to get those LEDs connected nice and tight. Remember, make sure that you had the legs on the right side. If you accidentally put the legs backward, it might not work. In that case, you could try flipping your battery over and testing it. Mine will not work, okay, because my legs are facing the direction they were supposed to, so I have to have positive side up. All right, so try a couple different things and have fun making your light up card.